Hello students, welcome to our online revision classes. In this class, you won't be discussing each and every sentence of your book, but rather, we will be highlighting all the things that we are going to revise now. So today, you will be learning about the landforms of the earth, as well as you will be learning effects of land and water on humans. So by this topic, we will conclude the unit. So, when we look around, we see land in different shapes and sizes. Am I right? Yes. At some place it is flat and other places it is raised. A natural salt surface of land is known as landform. Okay. So where we live on, where we walk, a natural and it is a solid surface that we could move around. And that surface is known as landforms. So now let us learn about some of the landforms now. Are you ready, students? So we will be discussing about mountains, plains and plateaus. So these are the landforms that we are going to discuss today, and you also will be learning about the differentiation of both. Okay, so we are first, let me tell you what landforms are that we know. A natural salt surface of land is known as landforms. Okay, and there are different types of landforms on earth. So the types that we are going to discuss is plains, plateaus and mountains. So when I talk about mountains, what is the first thing that hops into your mind? Yes, of course, our Mount Everest. A natural elevation of Earth's surface by considerable mass, generally a steep side, is called as mountains. So when you look up at the mountains, they are the highest landforms of the Earth. Am I right, students? It has the highest landforms. Can you see the video that is going behind, how high it is? And it also has the temperature difference. So mountains has a sloping side. Can you see the sloping side? And all the mountains have the peak. Okay, so it has the highest point. And the low-lying areas between the mountains are called as valleys, and rivers flow through the valleys. It is very cold near the peak, and hence they are covered in a snow most of the time. The next thing is, when we talk about mountains, the mountains that India has are famous Kashmir Valley, and Kanchenjunga is the highest mountain part of, can you tell me where it is located? Yes, it is located in Himalayas. So this is the features of mountain. But when we talk about hills, what is the thing that you can see? A hills are lower than the mountains, and it is easier for us to climb. For example, India are Nilgiri Hills, located in Kerala and Tamil Nadu, and some of the hills that are located in Meghalaya. And when we compare both the mountains and the hills, we can see mountains have steep slopes. Hills does not have steep slopes. And mountains are difficult to climb, and hills are easier to climb. They have a pointed tops called peaks. And for example, is our Mount Everest. And they do not have a pointed tops. Okay. And where you can see some people living there. For example, Nilgiris, Ooty. Okay. So these are the difference between mountain and hills. Now let us see about plateaus. So when we talk about plateaus are a raised area of land with a flatter top. So it will be different from mountain. So mountains have a jagged peak, like a peak surface on the top, but plateaus have a very flat surface over the mountain. Okay, plateaus form either when mountains get worn down and their tops are not as, okay. So this is the difference between plateaus and mountains. Okay, the plateaus are the other that two raised platforms. So it has hills and mountains, and there is another form of landform which is raised. However, this landform does not have a peak surface, it has a flat surface. Can you see, students, how flat it is? But it looks like a mountain and it has a flat surface. So this is called plateaus. So when we talk about plateaus, it does not have a peak. They often have a steep slope, one or more slides. So India has the largest plateau called Deccan Plateau. To its location on the map, you can see that it has a Deccan Plateau right in the middle. Okay, so this is how the plateaus are represented. Now, can you see the plateaus here? Yes, of course, it has a height of a mountain, but you have a flat surface over there. So this is the best example of plateaus. Okay, students. Now let us segregate plains like plateaus and mountains. Mountains has a raised piece of land, but plateaus has a raised piece of land. So your peak has, you have a peak in the mountain, but here you have a flat top. Okay, now let us discuss the last point, that is plains. An extension level, usually plains are the surface where we are living. Perambur is the best example of a plain area. Okay, so plains, can you tell me how the plains are? Of course, plains is a flat piece of land and it is used for farming, and they are found around rivers. So this is what plains are. Can you see how the plains are? Yes, of course, students. So plains in India is the northern plains and the coastal plains. Okay, so the difference between the plains, plateaus and mountains, can you get it? Plains is a flat land, mountain is a raised piece of land, plateau is a raised piece of land. But plains is flat, mountain has peak, and plateau has a flat top. So this is the difference between plains and plateaus. Okay, students. So when we talk about plains, plateaus and what? Plains, plateaus and mountains, we discussed how the structure it is, how the structures are made. Okay, so unlike mountain, hills are a small area and it is easy to climb. Okay, so you should know the difference between mountain and hill, and mountains, plains and plateaus. Now let us move on to the effects of land and water on human beings. When you see different types of places, some are coastal region, some have high elevated mountain, and some people live in valleys too. So what happens is, each and every human or the people that live around the certain climatic conditions or the places, their culture differs. Not only their culture, their food and clothing too. So people who live closest to river are likely to eat fish, okay, fish and other living beings in the water. Especially when the people are living around the coastal areas, they will tend to have the staple food as rice, you know, but their food will be mostly based on fish or seafood items. Likewise, clothing, when you go to the Kashmir area, your clothing differs because it is the colder climate there. The clothing differs from the plains that we live in. So just like food, land and water, it also affects how we live. For example, people living in mountains or hills are more likely to wear warm clothes to protect themselves from cold. Unlike mountain plains and colder regions where according to their seasons. Okay, so this is how the land and water affects on human beings. Okay, so this is the part that we revised today. Today we have revised about, let me give you a small recap of it. We have revised about plains, plateaus and mountain, and we also discussed about the difference between mountains and hill, and based on land and water, we discussed how the food and clothing are differed. Okay, students, shall we end up our session now? Okay, you have to have in your mind how the land and water affects on human beings. Okay, and also you learned today about mountains, plains, and can you tell me? Yes, mountains, plains, and plateaus. These are the topics that you have to have in your mind. So students, please complete your worksheet and be aware that you have to get signed from us when you need it. Thank you students. Thank you for your cooperation with us.